The last in the first session is our friend Robert Singer, chairman of Center for Jewish Impact. Thank you, Robert, for inviting me to attend this meeting in Albania, Tirana. Even it was virtual, I think we make some progress with Albanian friends. So, Robert, you have the floor.
Thank you. First of all, greetings from Tel Aviv that you see behind me, the line scale of Tel Aviv. And this is probably the only city in the world that anti-Semitism is not an issue that is being discussed on a daily basis. And thank you, high representative, for putting together this meeting, and to your staff, to your chief of staff, Nihal Saad, because I think that this meeting is extremely important. And thank you to Secretary General. Now, for me, the issue of anti-Semitism is not only organizational; it's also a personal. And I would like to give also some personal angle on this. As a member of family of refuseniks, I spent 4 years in Ukraine, in the former Soviet Union, having on a daily basis being blamed before the whole school of only one reason, of my willingness to live in my own country, and the anti-Semitism was felt there from day one. And as somebody who is a second generation of Holocaust survivors, and most of my family was killed during the Holocaust, and somebody who lost half-sister on her way escaping to Central Asia and saved there by the Muslim population, I can understand it also on a personal level. But even today, as a former senior officer at IDF and senior official in the Israeli government, while my countrymen are being accused by ICC, which is clearly a double standards and has a lot of anti-Semitic allegations in this, I really experience all this on a personal level. I'm involved in a struggle fighting, combating anti-Semitism for a few decades. I don't think that this problem is going to be resolved at this meeting, or I even would say that I don't think it will be resolved in the next few decades. But we shouldn't rest 1 minute fighting it with all tools available. Now, some of the things that need to be done, obviously mentioned in your paper, and some were mentioned here by some of my colleagues, and I really don't want to repeat them. So from my perspective, as a chairman of the Center of Jewish Impact and as a chairman of the Board of Trustees of World Org, anti-Semitism is a pandemic, and the main vaccine to fight this pandemic is by taking it out of shadows and out of dark and dark net, and bring it to the light, and fight the ignorance with only one tool in the long run, which is education, education, and education. That's what I did as the CEO of the World Jewish Congress under the leadership of President Ronald Roder, with the We Remember campaign that reached over 2 billion people in 2 years. And that's what I did as the CEO of the World Jewish Congress, working with UNESCO and the educational initiative. And that is what World Org is doing today, working in dozens of countries on non-Jewish programs, international cooperation programs that bring together Jewish and non-Jewish people together, Christians, Muslims, and many others. And I think we have to do more. And this will also what we are doing. I'm doing today with as an advisor, the Combat Anti-Semitism Movement that my colleague will speak later about, with the Balkans event that you mentioned, or with the special event for dozens of mayors from around the world that will take place in 2 days. So in the long run, in my opinion, this is the main solution, to educate and to eliminate the ignorance. I do want to express some optimism, exactly like you said. Parliaments, government, agencies, universities are accepting Cairo area definition and doing a proper legislation in more and more countries, and we have it on a daily basis. A 100 miles journey always starts with one small step. The 8 recommendations that you high representatives expressed at the beginning of this session, of this webinar, is exactly what needs to be done, and more should be added to it. And just to finish really this session, because I'm trying to keep it too short, and I would like to join my teacher, Rabbi Arthur Schneier, that I go with him for at least the last 30, 35 years in fighting for Soviet Jewry and many other projects. And Katerina and Malcolm and what you said, the only way to win this battle or to win this battle step by step are doing it together. And only together we will prevail. Thank you.
Thank you, Robert, for your intervention. And thank you for having this voice from Israel, from Tel Aviv. You know, I serve in Israel. I live in Tel Aviv and I miss, you know, so I'm sure you have a nice weather today. So we here in New York, it's okay, but it's cold anyhow. So thank you very much for enhancing what you say. It's a pandemic. It's a virus. We have to bring it to light and education. I think we all agree about that. We have to eliminate ignorance and we are going to follow your recommendation. Also to include everybody, including cities. And I think during this conference, you will hear some specific intervention related how cities, municipalities can contribute to a better fight against anti-Semitism. I disagree with you in certain issues. I mean, of course, we are not going to solve anti-Semitism today in this meeting, but my commitment is that in 1, 3, 4 years, no more, we will be able to have a better stand. So let's be optimistic. Let's join forces in order that in 1 decade, we will say what we have committed ourselves during the last years has produced concrete results. Anyhow, that is my optimistic will and my way to confront challenges and elements and problems. And so we hope that we can work together with the same spirit. So we have now put an end to the first panel.